The Shallows, What the Internet is Doing to Our Brains by Nicholas Carr. Maybe you were supposed to do something important right now but got distracted by a notification. Or maybe you thought it was a good time to check your social media again. It's been 10 minutes after all. The internet has been turned into a network of interruptions and notifications and hyperlinks and multimedia, and now when we're reading we skim more. We have a harder time reading long articles because the way we interact with the internet has reshaped our mind. Previously we thought that the mind was static after you reached an adult age, but research has shown that neuroplasticity, you know what I mean, it's true, and our brain is constantly changing after how we use it. The media, rather than the content, changes how we act and think, and the tools that we use, they numb the parts of our brain that the technology amplifies. A GPS is a great example. When we start to use the GPS, we diminish and weakens the ability to map out areas in our mind. And I guess I'm not the only one who have noticed that my handwriting has become pretty sucky since I started to write exclusively on computers and on phones. Deep reading, like reading this book, it takes deep concentration, and it has to be learned because our intelligence hinges on our ability to transfer information from the short-term memory to the long-term memory and weave them into conceptual schemas or complex concepts, and being able to focus on one thing for a longer duration of time is key for this type of understanding to be established. This book, The Shallows by Nicholas Carr, is extremely interesting, and it explains a lot of behavioral changes that I've seen in my own life in recent years, and it also discusses the science behind how internet browsing has changed the way we learn and how we think. And I can't recommend this one enough. One of the more enjoyable part of this book is the short history where he talks about different media being introduced throughout time and how they've changed the human perspective. I think you can't really go wrong with this one if you're interested in internet history and just psychology and behavioral stuff. So pick up this book, The Shallows.